Hi, my name is Leo, and I'm a chemist here in the Xiao Lab at the University of Washington, and a graduate fellow with the Clean Energy Institute. In the Xiao Lab, we're part of the Department of Chemistry, and we work on the fundamental science behind some of the technologies you see every day and some of the technologies we hope you will one day see. We design molecules to filter water, store all sorts of fuels, and even build advanced solar cells. Our materials are what's called porous, which you can think of like being bigger on the inside than the outside. They're so big that if you took just one teaspoon of our material and unfolded it all the way, it would cover an entire football field. We're proud to work towards the CEI mission of improved energy storage and transport, and grateful to work with the CEI here at the University of Washington. So this is the layout of a typical lab in the chemistry department. We have student offices in the front, and we do all our chemistry back here. Come on, and let's show you some of the instruments we use to do our work.
At UW, we make safety a priority, which is why we always wear lab coats and safety glasses when we're working. Additionally, some of the chemicals that we work with can be rather dangerous. They can catch fire or even explode when they come in contact with air. Because of that, we work with them in these big boxes that are filled with nitrogen gas and don't have any air in them. We can go in using these Darth Vader-style gloves and do our experiments totally safely. This is Cathleen. She's working in the glove box right now. She's setting up an experiment where she makes crystals for ultra energy efficient batteries. For slightly less dangerous chemicals, we like to work with them in a fume hood like this, which pulls any toxic or smelly vapors up and out of the room so that we don't breathe it in.
We use some really cool instruments to analyze our molecules to ensure that one, we made the right thing, and two, see how they work when we put them inside of batteries. This instrument here fills our materials up with gas. It fills up all the nooks, crannies, and holes, and we can measure how much gas was filled up to learn about their properties. And this is our solvent system, which keeps our chemicals really nice and pure, so that way we can go and use them in the nitrogen-filled glove box.
We can't use a regular camera to image our crystals, since they're just too small. So we have a few instruments to help us image them, allowing us to see our crystals and even the molecules that make them up.
We can use this instrument to shine X-ray radiation at our crystals and see how it bounces off to build a picture, kind of like when you go to the doctor's to get an X-ray. We can see how the crystals are shaped or if they're broken, like when you have a broken arm, and if they are broken, we can find new ways to heal them.
So bringing all the pieces together, we design crystals and engineer molecules to build better batteries, advanced solar cells, and even purify water. We think that the chemistry that we do is not only really cool, but also critical for building a greener future. We hope that some of you will become scientists and join us in the laboratory one day to help us solve some of the greatest challenges the Earth is currently facing.